Oh, a 2-minute tip on surface variable pressure. This is the type of stuff that gets me out of bed in the morning. I mean, just thinking about coming into work to talk about variable pressures, oh, wonderful. Anyways, my name's James Herzing. I'm a technical consultant. So, what do we have to do? Just a few things to define. The load orientation, the active function, really that's just typing a name in, and the expression. So the expression is, how is our force, or pressure in this case, I'm sorry, going to change over, say, the length of our part. Tip I would suggest before we get into the software, you can see it grayed out right here, this view button. Click it to make sure that you didn't type your expression in wrong. You want to make sure that your load is accurate to what you want it to be defining. Some of us make mistakes on occasion, not necessarily me, but maybe you do. Click on view, ensure that everything worked out right. All right, let's go see how this works inside of the software. All right, so we have our model set up. We even have some boundary conditions applied. If we choose to select this surface, we can then click setup, click on the more loads option, and then variable pressure. Let's drag this screen down so I can actually reach. And we're going to choose to use a normal to surface loading option, and then type in an active expression. So let's be creative here. Let's call it, I don't know, surface variable, load, or pressure. We don't need to be that creative. Hey, load, there we go. So now an expression. Important to note, although it's working off of the dimensions in X, Y, or Z, so increasing or decreasing our load respectively, our variables are R, S, and T. So R equals X, S equals Y, T equals Z. We do that just to make things more complicated on you. It helps keep me employed. So let's type an expression in here. We're going to make it pretty simple. We're going to have a base value for our pressure, like 100, and have it change with respect to the y direction. So in this case, the y direction is s. So again, s is equal to y. Type in 100 plus s, or the y direction, and now let's click on the view button to see what it looks like. You see, it looks like nothing changes. That's because we're looking at X right now. If we click that radio button for Y, you can see that our pressure is going to change as expected. It's going to go from smaller to larger based on the height in Z. You could see that some of it was actually below 100 psi. That's because some of this part is created in negative space. So it's going from somewhere around 75 up to somewhere above 100. Let's verify that our arrows are going in the right direction by analyzing. If we flip this into a nice view, you can see again, down here is where it's below the 100 mark, so it's our smaller pressure, and it increases the higher we get through our model. Pretty simple, and you can see why it gets me so excited and get out of bed in the morning. It's really what I live for. Anyways, if you have any questions on this, feel free to reach out to me at the Sim Squad. Also, if you have any suggestions for other videos or tips that you'd like to see, send them my way and I'd be happy to create them for you. Thanks a lot. Bye.